Hello everyone, and welcome back to Firewatch. It's now day two. So I guess I have to actually pick up the radio. I should probably reply, right?
I'm awake. What's your problem?
Our problem.
Sorry, our problem.
That storm knocked out the phone line I used to talk to the service, which means we're cut off. I tried radioing out, and that's not working either.
He stares into your soul.
I don't really know why that would be the case.
Can I go fix it?
Well, you probably can't, but what you can do is hike out to where the wire runs through your area and report back if it's down. Then I can track down a ranger to get someone on it.
Okay, I can do that. Where is it?
Remember that cave you hiked through yesterday?
Yeah, of course.
So you're going to want to go back there, go through it, and keep going straight to the north when you come out.
Will do.
Thanks, Hank.
It's Henry.
What, you don't like Hank?
Yeah, I don't like Hank.
But thanks rhymes with Hank.
No, it doesn't.
No, it doesn't.
Okay, all right.
At least those are still where I left them. Moved my perks. Frickin' dicks. I had them neatly organized. Now I don't even know which ones I had them in order with. If you could pick up the fireworks, but I don't want to pick up the fireworks. I got that move. I heard the thing you could confiscate the fireworks again. That's just silly. Two arts maps now. Stay. You two forest burns. There's glory. There we go. My antler too. Good, good. Everything looked according. That's not where I want to put that. A photo of Julia. Whiskey. Put back. I can't put back things. I can put back things instead of just tossing them. Eh. Come on. There we go. You say put back and then you toss it. I'm like, game. Come on. What part put... It's gonna be one of these days, isn't it? Put... What's that? So bloody hard. Ugh. Should really fit to that window. Anyway, time to go off and explore. Again. Guess it's day two. Hop over what? Oh. Why would would I want to do that? I don't understand. Okay, so where am I going? North. North, 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 north. North would be the outhouse way, right? Yes, north.
I feel like I'm gonna be murdered when I'm in the outhouse.
Feeling a little exposed, are we?
Hey, no man in the history of the world has felt tough with his pants around his ankles.
Well, be strong. You can always call if you're having trouble.
Sure, I'll do that.
I'm not sure how to reply to that. That's just mildly suggestive. Mildly.
Hey, I can see your tower. Suppose that means you can see me.
Yeah, well enough. You're at the canyon wearing the orange backpack, I presume.
Yep, that's me.
Also, you need a new barber.
Jeez, do you have the Hubble telescope over there?
Just kidding. You're just a little blob to me.
You wake up pretty early then, huh?
As soon as the sun comes up. Forest Service really frowns on us putting up curtains for some reason.
I just covered my head with my pillow. Seems to do the trick.
Wow. The forest could never burn down on your watch.
Oh, it's actually pretty damn cold out here.
Roger that. Warms up fast. The mornings are cold in Boulder, though, right?
Yeah, they are.
What did you get up to down there? I mean, what's life like?
What happens with the alcoholic?
Boring, if you don't ski. We used to go to this bar called the Dollar, though. I love that place.
Oh, wait, is that down on Pearl? They have all the money pinned to the ceiling?
Yeah, that's it, yeah.
I love that bar. Why don't you go anymore?
I got a DUI, so...
Oh.
Yeah, not particularly proud of it.
Well, I mean... Look, I haven't told anyone this, but, I got one, too, 5 years ago.
Yeah?
Yeah. God, it was stupid. It was so stupid, but, you know, it's late, it's winter, the streets are empty, and you just want to get home.
Totally.
Ugh, so fucking dumb. Hey, can you hold on a sec?
Sure. Just gonna keep hiking and hoping it warms up.
Heyo. I don't think so. Why, have you? Okay, good. No, I don't think he has any idea. I'm absolutely sure. Would you? All right, I'll let you know if anything changes in that regard. Hey, sorry about that. Anyway, I empathize with the DUI thing. Did your, girlfriend get mad, or whoever? You said we used to go to the bar. Ugh, sorry, I'm the most awkward woman on Earth.
That would be my wife, Julia.
Oh, like your wife, or like she's taken half my stuff wife?
My wife.
But you're here.
Right.
She's sick, and I shouldn't be here, but I am.
I'm sorry, Henry. What is it?
We'll get into it.
Okay. Well, in the meantime, you are here, and it's beautiful, and escaping isn't always something bad.
Yeah, sure.
Look, I gotta go do a thing, but I'll have a radio. Okay, call me if you need to.
Yeah, about that, though. Yeah.
I can see the wire you're talking about. It looks like it's in good shape from here.
Well, follow it up to the top of the trail if you can. You can head back as soon as you give me the all clear.
Got it.
Hmm. Could you have been talking about us? Questions.
So we really can't reach anyone any other way than these wires?
What else do you suggest? Smoke signals?
Just seems dangerous.
Well, if they don't hear from me for a few days, they'll send someone out, but I'd rather it not come to that.
Hey, I found a structure that might have been an outhouse once, I think.
Whoa, you don't need my permission to go to the bathroom, but, you know, use abandoned shitters at your own peril.
You mean I'm in the right area?
I do believe. The comms wire runs for quite a ways. Follow it all the way to the top of Beartooth Point, and if it's not damaged, you can loop around back home.
I found an old notepad of, I guess, songs. Someone was writing a song called Old Shoshone.
Old Shoshone, where the sky is blue and the teens are nude.
Old Shoshone. Frame, I'm heading out to Old Shoshone, where the birds and the bees won't know me. We're men in the war, don't exist no more, and there ain't no gals to keep no score. Taking off for the woods to a place where there ain't no shows. Don't need no Burks, I'll ponder the ponderosas. Don't need no lady, I'll marry the Mariposas. God, this is bad. No.
It's just like that, except about 10 times more depressing.
I'm gonna keep it. Of lock months. Thankfully, all the codes are 1, 2, 3, 4. No, you fool. 1, 2, 3, 4. There's a hat.
Huh. Found an old hat from a Korean war vet.
You'd be surprised how many former service members take this gig.
Well, makes sense.
I imagine if you've been through war, you probably can't get enough silence.
Well, I'm taking the hat, and I'm putting it on. Because, if this is anything like Team Fortress 2, obviously hats are important, and collecting them is important.
Anything I should know about the cabin at the top of this hill? Hello? Okay, then.
Okay, then. Well, ominous. Not a bad toss, though, actually. Have a special raccoon to pop out of that. Looks like it used to be a lookout post. Used to be. That's a tree. You should not run into them. Despite how easy it is to run into trees. Perp, perp, perp. More utility poles. I think that's the one we're looking for, though.
Can you see the communication wires from where you are?
I can see the poles, but I have no idea if the wire is in good shape or not. They run a good distance up to a spot called Beartooth Point. You just need to walk along them all the way up there and make sure everything's in ship shape.
More lock boxes. Huzzah. Copy information. Guess it's useful. Map is updated. Another note.
Hey, who are these guys, Ron and Dave? They're leaving.
Oh, I shouldn't have interrupted that. By the way, Dave, heyo, I got your note, but I need to talk. Sorry I didn't track you down. Been looking for you all day. Figured you'd be out near the canyon helping those grad students, but I guess not. Don't even know how I could really help, anyway. We're co-workers, you know. Amigos. Professionals. Professionalities. If you need someone to throw a case back with and go time traveling, Ron's your guy. But I'm not great with the life stuff. You get later, Ron.
Notes for each other in the boxes. Is there any chance one of them was that guy I saw in the canyon? You know, the guy with the flashlight?
No, they're both rangers. They're not out here this season. I didn't really know him that well, but I always assumed the only thing Ron cared about was chasing tail and getting loaded. It's somehow comforting to know that he was able to keep up a correspondence with someone who wasn't going to send him a topless Polaroid.
I want the perk. Screw everything out, I want the perk. I'm taking it with me. I can put it in my perk collection. Because it's another Richard Sturgeon perk. Oh god, just think of the effort of actually getting all of the perks back. Oh god.
Yeah, okay, the wire's down here.
Really? Awesome. Could find.
It's like, I don't know, a mile and a half east of me. You just follow the trail up the hill, you can't miss it. I'll go see what the damage is.
Oh, I have to actually get up to, though. Six feet down under. I can't look at while running. I guess that would be a stupid thing to do. So yeah, I get to just run around, not actually talking too much, and enjoying the game. Good for Let's Play purposes.
Guess what?
What is it?
There's a bunch of empty cans up here.
Same as before?
Yep.
These fucking kids.
Yeah, I would clean them up, but I have a book.
How can these girls be so stupid?
Trust me, I never underestimate the stupidity of a drunk teenager. Also, I never underestimate the balls of a drunk young woman, having been one.
So yeah, well, I could clean up all those cans and get magical, non-existent points on my good guy meter. I'm just going to leave them.
Hey, so the wire is definitely down out here. I just found it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the thing is, it doesn't look like the wind. It looks like it was cut deliberately.
I knew it. The moment you said you found their trash. These idiots are gonna pay. Do they realize this is how people die? I mean, what if something happened to one of my lookouts while this was going on? And God forbid there's an actual fire burning out of control.
What do you want to do?
I want you to go find them.
And then what?
I haven't thought that far ahead. That's not true. Everything that comes to mind is illegal.
Let's hear it.
Oh yeah?
Hey, I came out here for a breath of fresh air and some adventure. What do you got?
I think I want you to just find them and scare the hell out of them.
Yeah, I'd make a spooky ghost costume, but they stole my sheets.
I don't know. Wait for them to wander off and wreck their camp. Something that would make a teenage girl run home to mommy and daddy.
I'll find them.
Thanks.
But I am gonna need a raise.
Don't hold your breath. I'd start by hiking back towards your tower and just keep an eye out for anything that would lead you to them.
Well, they're big into Red Eagle.
Great. See if you can find the path they took down from there. Maybe they looped back around towards the lake or something.
They can't tell.
I doubt they're where they were yesterday, but they obviously can't have gone far.
Apparently I can't tell them that. Oh well. Onwards we go. Why carry this bark back? Hip, hip, hip. So now technically we have to go. Oh god, I can't even look at my map without. All the way from here to down there again. Ish. Somewhere there-ish. Yeah, that's gonna be difficult. But first, the exploration. And there's nothing in the supply cache, eh? Oh well. I still have my book. Yay, book.
Hey, I'm out at a ravine. What's this thing that spans across it?
That is how you get to my sector.
No kidding. Well, let me hike over.
Well, it's locked up and mainly for emergencies. I've never actually used it. Rangers use it from time to time, but that's it.
Help! Oh, God, it's an emergency!
Oh, really?
Yeah, I got eyes on a tornado! I gotta get out of here!
A tornado in the heart of the Rockies?
Yes!
Holy moly, I need to call this in! Tom, Two Forks sees a tornado! He says he needs an evac into my sector. It's a meteorological impossibility? There haven't been tornadoes in the greater Yellowstone region in 100 million years? You're gonna need him to stay and take a detailed personal account, even if it means giving his life! Okay, I'll tell him. Sorry, Hank. No dice.
Man. Do you see anything from yours, like, you know, like clues as to where they could be?
Clues. I really like your enthusiasm for mystery.
I'm just mystery. Doing my job.
I like it. I do. I just... I can't wait for you to give these girls a piece of your... our... mind. Minds. Collective. But no. No clues. I can't see anything from here.
Heh. I still have the park. Yeah. Such effort. Hip, hip, hip.
There's an abandoned pack out here.
And it's not one of the teens?
Stay. No, it looks like it was lost a long time ago.
Well, you could always pilfer it for supplies.
Yeah. Seriously, swipe. Can't be burnt. Well, we found a camera. Camera, God. And rope.
Well, I am flush with ropes now. That pack was full of them, in decent condition, too.
That's lucky.
I mean, there's enough rope here that I could just leave them hooked up, I think. Oh, get this. This pack came with one of those cardboard single-use cameras.
With pictures left?
Yeah, he only used 3 or 4.
Neato.
Thank you, Brian Goodwin.
Wait, who?
The bag had the name Brian Goodwin sewn into the top.
Huh. Wow.
Do you know him?
Yeah, I just haven't heard that name in a few years.
Oh, this is gonna be silly, but...
What, was he a fella you had a thing with?
Yeah. It was so hot and heavy. Of course, Brian Goodwin was 12 years old, so, you know, our love could never really be understood.
Dot.
I'm kidding. Not about him being an actual 12-year-old. That part's true. He was stationed in Two Forks, your lookout, with his dad, Ned, 3 summers ago. Great kid.
You can bring children out here?
This is going to be difficult to work out.
You know, I'm not a stickler for rules. They took off halfway through the summer.
Why? Where did they go?
I don't know. I never really hit it off with old Ned. And, one day they were just gone. Sucks. Anyway, so it goes. Have, fun with that camera. Try not to snap anything that would scar a photo dome employee.
I don't know. I got a lot of hiking to do. Might get bored.
Well, I'm bored as rocks, so I'll keep you company while you find those girls, huh?
Huzzah. Seriously, the effort to get this work back. Map information. Seriously, I don't understand why I can't have just a put in my backpack option. By the way, can we put the note? I'll let you read. Dave, guess who's going out with Debbie next week? Nope, not that shit, hey old Steve, it's your man Ron. Why don't you check with the new guy, Tufo Forks, and heard him talking to himself? More than usual for arrows, so I figured I'd stay away. Remember when you saw Chimney Rock having himself in that hammock? I was trying to think the Forsters were in pits to deranged and preferred it. Except for us, of course, with the creme de la creme. Let's toast to Deb at the spot. Rob. Keep. Who knows what I'm going to do for all that, but yeah.
Someone found a fossil and put it in a cash box.
Could be the same person who left that antler.
Maybe they're leaving me an entire creature, piece by piece.
A fossil, you say? But I can't carry both. Sad face. And thus we left the fossil. We left a frickin' fossil.
What does she
behind.
Have?
Oh, yeah.
She's got Alzheimer's. Like, dementia.
Whoa. How old was she?
Is she? She's alive. She's with her family in Melbourne, Australia. She's 43.
Fuck.
Yeah.
What was it like when you guys found out?
I don't want to report that thing, but...
Devastating. Especially for her. You can understand.
And for you.
Anyway, everything she worked for was taken away, and that was it. Yeah. I'm sorry to be such a downer.
Don't even. I'm happy to listen. And, you know, we'll try to have some fun this summer. I promise.
Okay, now I can report.
I see a really thin plume of smoke.
Yeah, I see it too. A thin plume like this is either a new fire or a campfire.
Campfire? You think it's them?
I reckon so.
It looks like it's to the southwest of me.
That's right. If you hike towards 5 Mile Creek, that should put you in the neighborhood. Keep an eye on that smoke plume. Let me know if it's getting any larger.
Will do. Hey, Delilah?
What do you got? You found him?
No, not yet. Why would there be a fence out here?
Because sometimes hikers go ass over tea kettle when on a trail.
So the Forest Service would put up a big chain link fence?
A chain link fence?
Yeah. It looks like it surrounds a huge area.
But we can't climb the
That's
fence.
That's weird.
What do you think they're keeping in? What do they not want to have get out of there?
Oh, geez, so many things.
Should I just stop you now?
Maybe loads of hedgehogs.
Okay.
Thousands even, full percentage points of the global hedgehog population.
Uh-huh.
There's a lot of hedgehogs.
The New Zealand government is up in arms. Where are all the hedgehogs? Well, folks are hiding them all in Wyoming. That's where they are. Who would do that and why? Haha, that is the real mystery.
Really glad I kept you in the loop. Thanks for all of the... high-quality information.
Okay, okay. I'll ask what's up if I talk to someone in the next few days who I think might know.
Can we plant this burn tree? Plant the burn tree. That'll do. Don't know why, just wanted it. Onwards to glory and getting lost.
So, how'd you meet?
Met in a bar.
The birthplace of modern romance.
I stumbled over and told her she was pretty, and that was it.
Aw, you were brave.
Something about cheese.
I was drunk.
Guess this is the way down. I should drop this blight thing so I can see the map. Okay, so where am I? That way. I have to head down now. So back to that way and down. Yeah. Okay. And I have to drop this, attach the rope. Just wait, I'm gonna find a lockbox with like 5 Berks in it. Then I'm going to be sad. Because I can't carry all these Berks. Because apparently, even though we have a pack, we can't put the Berks in the pack. Can't take them back with us. Unless we actually carry them with one hand.
Wow, I'm on top of a natural bridge out here.
Really? Is it a complete arch?
No, I guess the bridge is out here. Still, I think I could jump this gap to get across the canyon.
Wow, you're a regular Evel Knievel.
Oh yeah, you should see the jumpsuit I'm wearing.
Yeah, here's the thing. We're technically ill. We technically can go that way to Jonesy Lake. Or we could do this. We can go across the canyon. And then do some climbing as music starts to play. Hopefully not copyright. Not a very long drop down. That guy should be back here, which means if I go this way, I should be back to the path I need to go. And now that I have rope, should be able to progress. Huzzah. Huzzah for having rope. In this book.
What are you gonna do when the fire season wraps up? Are you gonna go be with her? Just go back to Boulder?
Maybe I'll go visit. I don't know.
Well, why not?
She's with her family in Melbourne. They're not big fans of mine.
Oh.
Her sister, Susan, is great, but her parents, I think they always thought she could do better. And that I could have done a better job looking after her.
Fuck that. I have no doubt you did your best.
I don't know.
If you want to go visit her, you should go. Don't let a couple of assholes keep you away from someone you love.
I'll think about it. I'm down by Cripple Gulch.
You ready to give it another shot?
Oh, Do I seriously have to?
To get down to Five Mile Creek? Yeah, afraid so. It's quite a ways downhill from here.
Okay, so here's the thing. Remember those choices I made? That one that said, I prefer inside a home? Right, well here's the thing. If you choose the hoe, you decide to take care of the thing. Eventually, it goes down to a path where it's like, her parents came to visit, didn't like to stay at the of your home that she was living in, so they took her back with her to Melbourne. And you didn't argue with it. And you were going to visit, and then, well, you took the job. But here's the thing. Nowhere the path we took, she shouldn't have ended up in Melbourne. Because she was supposed to be in, you know, that home. That was near where we boat her. And that we were going to go visit. But, well, we were visiting, but we took this job, and, you know. So, just a few complications there with the story. Backstory, anyway. Like I'm still carrying this bark. I could totally have gone back to 2 forks just to do that with the bark, but oh well. We're almost there, I think. And look at another lockbox. Yay, lockboxes. Copy the map information. Pine cones.
How many hikers go missing in the Shoshone?
More than none, unfortunately, with most of them being in this area. A thoroughfare because it's so remote. Why?
I found an old flyer for a missing hiker. It just got me thinking, that's all. Like how you said one day you were talking to the Goodwins, and then the next you weren't.
Ned Goodwin didn't get mauled by a bear or stuck in a ravine. He was just a PTSD'd a-hole who dragged his son out to do a job and realized it was a bad idea.
You really didn't like that guy, did you?
I don't know. I just had a hard time talking to him. I mean, there are lookouts who seriously won't shut up, who call me about every little thing that pops into their head. And then there are those who just want to be left alone.
You mean how I report everything?
He was the latter.
And I'm the former, aren't I?
Yeah.
Well, I didn't want to say anything.
No, it's fine. I'll just chuck my walkie-talkie into the river.
Oh, come on.
And you'll never hear from me again.
Finally, peace and quiet! Woohoo!
So,
isn't your radio supposed to be in the river?
I couldn't bring myself to do it.
Well, I guess I'm stuck with you then.
Yeah. So, did you mention something about Ned Goodwin having PTSD? That doesn't sound good.
Yeah, I don't know. He was in the army. He was off. It's actually the saddest story. He was only discharged because his mother, Brian's grandmother, died. She'd been taking care of him, and Ned was the only next of kin.
Damn. And you got to know Brian a little bit?
Yeah. I talked to him way more than I'd talked to Ned, that's for sure.
How was he at, spotting fires?
Better than you. He actually liked to stay in the tower.
Boy, for as dry as it is this summer, there's an area down here that's lush.
Oh, you must be talking about the Aspen Grove down there.
Yeah, I think that's where I am.
Those trees are actually one root organism. Did you know that? Can you believe you're actually getting paid to learn all of these amazing things? Also, by what it looks like on this map, you'll be coming up on a stream that should lead you towards where we saw that smoke.
Hey look, a stream. So let's see, follow that and we should be fine. Huzzah.
Hey, what's to the south of here?
Mexico? Is this some sort of riddle?
I just have a nice view to the south. You know, trees and mountains forever.
Well, eventually you'll wander into the area overseen by Chimney Rock Lookout, but that's probably an impossible hike in terms of terrain.
There's some cloth out here. It looks like it was torn from something.
Strange.
I'll keep looking around. It's a really nice waterfall down here. Given those girls love a skinny dipping, I bet they're nearby.
There we go. Like it's died down.
I see a campsite and it looks like they've got a fire.
Is it them?
That seems like it. I swear, they must have dragged 4 cases of beer out here.
Track them down and don't let them see you.
What a job this is. These girls have a full case of beer left here. A full case.
Well, they're impressive little shits, I guess.
That is some dedication.
How much beer did they bring with them?
I have entered the teen zone.
Oh, really? And where's that?
It's the name of a magazine for girls. It's on the ground here at their camp. Huh, pants are back.
I'm sorry, pants are back?
According to the experts at Teen Zone magazine, it's unclear where they've been. The pants, I mean.
I found my sheets!
So they did break into your tower.
Looks like.
Those are my sheets. Good news. I don't think we can carry them back, though. Oh god, Burks and everything. Report dangerous hunks.
Well, I found some dangerous hunks.
What on earth are you...
It's another one of those magazines. I don't get why the hunks have to be so dangerous.
Well, you're clearly not a young woman.
Girls should want nice hunks.
Ugh, boring.
Well, this... doesn't look good.
Their tent looks like it's been through the shredder, which would explain that scrap I found.
What could have done that? Like a bear or, I don't know, it sounds crazy, but even a bull elk if it's off its rocker.
Some of their clothes are all torn up.
That's not good.
You know, maybe I should take one of their sleeping bags as payback.
At this stage, take whatever you want.
Can I actually, though? No. No, I can't. I have to pick up the note, though. So you read... Dear Seneca, I hope you're fucking happy. We're leaving, and we're going to find the police or whatever and tell them about how you creeped on us in the lake. They came and destroyed our campsite and got all our stuff. I want you to join panties to screw us out. You're probably a mental fucking act murdering you. So going to jail. But it's worth being a jerk over some firewood stick. So it sounds like... someone else is trying to set them up. Because, you know, the stuff was over there at the Y or so. Someone else is involved. He's trying to play everyone against each other out here in the wilderness. I should probably report.
Oh, they're gone, for sure.
How can you tell?
Well, the girls left someone, me, I guess, a note.
Well, what's it say?
Threatening to call the police because they think I attacked them.
Oh my god, well, did you?
No, well, hey, I didn't do this, okay? Someone or something went to town here, but it wasn't me.
Because I told you to scare them, not assault them.
I didn't. Of course I didn't. I just threw their stereo in the lake.
Yeah, I really wish you wouldn't have done that.
That was worth it.
I don't know, weird as hell, but it wasn't me.
It's okay. I believe you. Weird stuff happens in the woods. It could be other campers. They could be having a bad mushroom trip. We really don't know, but... they're gone. There's no way to call the cops, they're not coming back, and we can get to work. I'd really like to start enjoying a quiet summer.
Yeah, me too.
Probably should just confiscate the stereo. But my book. My book. I also hope you all enjoy, thank you all, and have a nice day.